Hi everybody, this is the ninth video in my series about the chromatic harmonica. It's been a very, very long time since I posted my last video. I can only apologize for that, but I'm definitely going to pick things up again and post more videos. I've got a plan for the next five videos type of thing. So I now know what I'm going to do. In this one, I want to discuss what is a chromatic harmonica, what makes a harmonica chromatic, and how does the chromatic bit work on a chromatic harmonica. So that's what I want to talk about now. The chromatic harmonica is basically two harmonicas in one. So you play a normal diatonic harmonica, but then when you press the slider, that unhides another harmonica that's hidden behind. So the second harmonica is actually hidden. So when you press the slider, you choose between, say, harmonica 1 and harmonica 2. So the harmonica 1 is the one you normally play without using the button, and that's usually tuned to the key of C. So basically it's like a diatonic harmonica in the key of C, or if you've got a chromatic in the key of F, whatever. So the key that you normally play on a chromatic harmonica without using the slider, that's the key of your harmonica. Now in this case, mine is in the key of C. So if you don't use the slider, you just play a normal diatonic harmonica. What is a diatonic harmonica? It's the normal standard diatonic scale, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, or in any other language, it doesn't matter. So normally on a chromatic harmonica, if you don't use a slider, you will play like a normal diatonic harmonica, which gives you the tone ladder of the normal standard major key major scale. That's what you get when you just play a scale on the normal harmonica without using the slider, just using your breath pattern. Now the trick is that there's another harmonica, like I said, hidden behind the first harmonica. And the second harmonica that you activate with the slider is actually tuned a semitone higher. So if your harmonica is in the key of C, you press the slider and then you play the same thing in the key of C sharp or D flat, whichever you want to call it. So the trick is, hang on, how should I say this? So basically, technically speaking, the chromatic harmonica with the slider, so the two harmonicas switching between the two and the first and the second harmonica, gives you all the chromatic notes in a chromatic scale. What is a chromatic scale? Which means basically all the notes, including the black notes on a piano, keyboard, whatever. So the chromatic harmonica contains two harmonicas, two diatonic harmonicas. The one is tuned a semitone higher than the first one, and you choose between the two harmonicas by pressing or not pressing the slider. That then gives you all the notes in between the notes that are on your normal major diatonic scale. The first thing to do is, if you play any note on a chromatic, doesn't matter what, and you then press the slider, the note goes up by one semitone. Try it, and any note that you play anywhere on the harmonica, it doesn't matter. If you play the push the slider, it goes up by one semitone. listen carefully, try it yourself, play any note and then press the slider and you'll hear that the note goes up by one, what's called a semitone. What is a semitone? What is a whole note and what is a semitone? A whole tone, semitone. If you listen carefully, and this is all about listening to every note that you're playing. It's listening gives you an understanding. If you play the first three notes, so C, D, E, in a normal, so Do, Re, Mi, in a normal scale. And then you play the next note, which is an F. You can hear that there is something different in the distance between those notes. That's a whole note. That's a whole note. Ah, hang on, that's different. There's only half a note in between those. You can hear that those two notes are closer together. And that is how, what makes a chromatic harmonica actually chromatic. It gives you all the semitones. So really, if you play in one harmonica, let's just say one harmonica, and then in between you press the slider between every note, that gives you the full chromatic range. So really what it is the notes that you can't get on one harmonica, you can get on the other harmonica, which you can select by pressing the slider. That's how a chromatic harmonica works. It's difficult to explain. Why? Because it's down to listening. Really train your ears to understand the difference between a whole note and a semitone. There is another way where you can find out whether a note is a whole note apart or a semitone apart. If you play a C on a C chromatic, and then you play the next note, which is a D, how do you know whether that's a whole note or a semitone? And you can test that by pressing the slider. So the note with the slider, if it's a whole note, the slider note will be different from the next note. So how do I say this? So you play a C and a D, and with the slider you can test if there's a note in between or not. There's a difference between that's how you hear the difference between a whole note and a semitone. It gets more interesting, and this will explain it to you if you play, say, an E on a chromatic harmonica, normal standard, an E, which is blow two or blow six. And you play the next note, which is a draw note in the same hole. And now you play the E again, but then you press the slider. And that is exactly the same note. So the draw note in hole six is the same as the blow note with slider. if those two notes are the same, so the first note, the blow note, the note with the slider is the same as the next note, that would normally be a draw or whatever, then you know that there's only a semitone between those two notes. Basically, and it's, you can see this like a keyboard. If you look at the layout of a keyboard, as everybody knows, and now I've just make a quick drawing here. These are the normal note, the white keys on a piano are basically the notes that you play without the slider. So on harmonica one. So they're the notes, and the one, and then these notes, there's the ones in between, those you can play by using the second harmonica, the hidden, that's normally hidden, which is by using, pressing the slider. So to play this note, you just need the normal harmonica. To play the black note next to it, you just press the slider. I don't know if this makes sense. And what is the difference between a piano, let's say a keyboard, and a chromatic harmonica? A chromatic harmonica, like I said, the second harmonica hidden in there is an exact copy of the first harmonica. So, technically speaking, on a chromatic harmonica, you get a keyboard like this. Well, not just 2-3-2-3, but basically the chromatic harmonica is like a piano with all the black keys everywhere. Don't let this confuse you. And obviously, like I just explained, if you play an E and an E sharp is actually the same note as an F. And that is why on a normal keyboard, there's the odd few black keys missing, because the difference between those two notes is already one semitone. So you don't need another black key in between. And of course, it also helps you to navigate on a keyboard. If you need to know what note it is, it's very difficult to see the difference between all the white notes. So obviously the black notes help you to know where you are on the keyboard. On a harmonica, that's much more difficult because, like I said, there's a semitone, there's a higher up for every note on the whole keyboard. I don't know if this makes sense. It's quite difficult to explain, but it's just absolutely true, and maybe another way of looking at the chromatic harmonica and trying to understand the chromatic harmonica. So every note, like I said, try it out. Every note that you play on a chromatic harmonica without a slider, any note, and you then press the slider, the note goes up by one semitone. Try to figure out and try to get used to listening. Really listen carefully. The difference between a whole note and a semitone, and you can hear that by just playing notes, playing tone ladders. And then in between you press the slider every time. And at some point you come to the point where the two notes are exactly the same. So the one note with slider and then the next note, and those two notes are exactly the same. Then you know that there's only one semitone difference between those two notes. It happens between E and F. So E, you'll never see an E sharp because that's actually an F. E and F, there's only a half note semitone difference. And between B and C at the end of the tone scale ladder. So, say it in another language. Do, re, mi, fa, mi, fa, mi, fa. Between mi and fa, there's only one semitone, not a whole note. Do, re, mi, that goes up by whole notes. And the next one, mi, fa, that's only half. That's a semitone. They're closer together, those two notes. Right, that's pretty much what I want to say about this. I hope this helps you to understand how a chromatic harmonica is made what makes the chromatic harmonica actually chromatic. I am going to do, honestly, because I'm not going to leave it that long again for my next video. It's been a long time. There's been things been happening with me, and I don't think it's any excuse, but it started out when I recorded my last video. The comb of my tremolo chromatic broke, so I couldn't do anything, and I had to order a new comb. That took 4 months to come. So that was my first excuse, and then it was just a case of being busy, you know. Obviously in January last month, I don't know whether you know, anyone who know me will know that my wife and I both had COVID, so we were off sick for a few weeks. Thankfully we're all fully recovered, it's nothing too bad. Thankfully we didn't get it as bad as some other people have got it. Thankfully we both fully recovered, back at work and etc. So that's caused another delay, and there's other things. I mean, if you do videos, I have to have my head in the right place, and that wasn't the case for a long time. So I'm sorry for the delay, and I'm certainly going to do more videos, and it won't last as long this time to do the next one. I've got a plan already for the next 4 videos, and I'm going to talk about a very controversial subject, especially in the world of harmonica players, and that is reading music. I am a big fan of reading music, but I'll explain more about that, and that is going to be discussed in 4 different videos next. I've come up with a plan anyway, so hopefully the next video will be recorded soon, maybe next week I should think, and then I'll be talking about the subject of reading music. Why do I think you should read music? How does it help? So, you know, how does it help you? Why does it help you? How can it make you a better player? I'm also going to discuss a lot of myths and misunderstandings about reading music. And in the last video, I'm going to explain what you can expect if you decide to have a go at reading music. So anyway, that's going to be the next subject, which is going to be split out over the next 4 videos. I'll record that whenever I can. Soon, I promise. Thank you. Bye.